Hey guys, welcome back to How to Make Elements from Household Materials. Today's element is going to be tin. Specifically, I'm going to show an easy way to make finely divided tin, which is more useful than chunks of tin for chemical reactions. To begin, we can weigh out 32 grams of tin 4 oxide. This could be purchased at pottery supply stores. Next, we can measure out 5 grams of charcoal or another source of carbon. This is a stoichiometric excess of carbon, but this will ensure that all of the tin 4 oxide is reduced to elemental tin. These were then combined in a blender and ground together until completely homogenized. The reaction mixture was placed in a steel vessel with a lid, and this was placed inside of a tin can to help protect the inner tin from oxidizing under high heat. The tin can was then placed in a furnace, and a large propane torch was used to heat the reaction mixture until it was glowing yellowish-orange. It was held at this temperature for 10 to 15 minutes to ensure a complete reaction and help the tin coalesce. Once finished reacting, the furnace was turned off and allowed to cool. Upon emptying out the cooled reaction mixture, many small spheres of tin are immediately identifiable. The reaction mixture is added to a liter of water and stirred. The tin spheres settle out quickly, and the charcoal suspension can be decanted off. This is repeated several times to remove all of the excess charcoal. The tin was then added to a watch glass and heated on a hot plate to drive off the water. To leave it as powdered tin, just heat the tin on low heat. If a single piece of tin is desired, though, the watch glass can be heated above 232 degrees Celsius to melt the tin together. For most chemical reactions involving tin, having a higher surface area is favorable, however. In the end, 17.25 grams of finely divided tin was obtained, corresponding to a 68.5% yield based on the starting tin 4 oxide. The remaining tin is likely present as extremely fine particles mixed with the charcoal dust. If desired, hydrochloric acid could be added to the charcoal dust to dissolve the remaining tin, and it could be electroplated out of solution, but that could be saved for another project. This tin will be used specifically to make some tin 4 chloride, which is a very cool, highly reactive fuming liquid. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in a future project. Okay, bye.